have a son that's 11 who's like this tall already. And so the only thing I could think of was, shit, somebody, you know, they might see my son and feel threatened, and you know, something might happen, and they might kill my son. It's scary for me. I feel like I have 7 more years to hold on to my son as tight as I can and protect him. But then I know the day is going to come when he has to leave my household and like go away to college. So I feel like I have to be proactive right now to try to make some things change. That way when he does leave my household, maybe I can sleep better at night. Because right now, nah.
If an African-American male grows and survives 25 years in one day in this country, he's blessed. So you didn't catch that. America says, you know, maybe we did do something wrong and it needs to be corrected. If you can't get to that point, then all of the things that we propose for change, can it really take place until we all agree that something happened that needs to be corrected in the first place?
Scorcher. That we have about what's going on, whether it's in Baltimore, whether it's in Ferguson, whether it's here in our own backyard, and whether it's incidents of abuse or whether it's incidents of resistance to abuse. We're not going to stop organizing behind that. We're going to organize harder, and we're going to come at them harder and with more people every time.
Black Lives Matter is a human rights organization who basically fights for black lives. It's just as simple as that. It's kind of our way of affirming that we believe that our lives matter. Like, we are out here not because we don't have shit else to do, but because we think that we're important folks in this country too. Some countries have zero murders of their citizens. LA is leading the nation in police murders of its community members. It takes a lot of talking to the folks in the community to see what the issues really are. It's nonstop too. You have meetings in person, over the phone. You have conferences, national conferences, it's a lot.
A 25-year-old African-American died after he was
injured. If I could be in Baltimore right now, just assisting them, being to whatever use they would need from me to them, I would be there. These are my people. You know, these are my relatives.
I don't know if it's changing society as of yet, but there's a momentum building with this change. You can see it with the youth movement. You can see it with the adults coming out and joining the youth. So it's a step-by-step process. It's going to take a whole lot to reverse this evil.
Matter. All lives matter. And if we don't see that, then we've already lost. So we've got to start being committed about being solid human beings, and then we can change the whole entire world. But we've got to grow up. We've got to change. We've got to look at it holistically and not just in a simplistic what's happening in Los Angeles, what's happening in Baltimore. We've got to look at the entire world.
Every year, the median income for whites and blacks is expanding. Now, you would think with all of the education that blacks have, the educational level that blacks have achieved, that it would be closing, but it's not. Each year it widens and it widens. The median mean income widens and widens and widens between white and blacks. How come we're not focusing on that? How come we're not really trying to understand that? Why is that? But it's happening. We even now coming up with another classification on the census report called other. Other what? What is an other? Get out of here. Why not put human? No, we gotta put other for the separation. As long as we're willing to talk, there's hope.